Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. In today's video, guys, we'll show you how to remove and replace serpentine belt on Hyundai Elantra, guys. So we'll show you how to remove the belt, how to replace it, the serpentine belt diagram and all that stuff. Stay with us, guys. Let me just introduce you. We'll have more than 200 videos taking the whole car apart, the whole vehicle, taking the engine apart, everything. So please subscribe for all the work we do, and more vehicles and makes will come on the channel as well. And we have a brand new channel, Electrical Car Repair, and I will be uploading more electrical videos, engine codes, airbag codes, things like that for that car. So please give a subscribe. So in order to replace the belt now, we need to get that bolt loose on the alternator. Just get it loose, like one revolution. Okay, like that. We do that so we can get the belt loose. Now, right here, you can see that bolt there is with a 12mm. We need to get that one loose about one or two revolutions again. If you need guys help with anything, let us know. We'll try to make a video for you. Now, with the same 12mm but with extension, okay, we are going to go counterclockwise. Okay, and when you go counterclockwise, okay, the alternator starts dropping, and check out, the belt starts getting loose. It's getting more and more loose. Look at all the slack I have now. Make sure that nobody's inside to start the vehicle. Okay, we still need to go more. Let's see if that will be enough to slip the belt off the, maybe. Okay, off the alternator or the water pump. So, he will come off the water pump. Okay, like that. After that, you just need to pull it out of the way. You'll get stuck on the bottom. Okay, and this is, guys, the serpentine belt out of the car. Okay, you can see. We'll have the links for the parts and tools we use in the description of the video. So, now let's go ahead and install the belt and show you how to get it tight. So now, you get the belt. Okay, you need to go in an angle here a little bit so you can go past the water pump. Okay, it goes from the AC, okay, to the crankshaft pulley there, so I need to go back on the crankshaft pulley now. And you can do that easier if you remove the engine undercover on the bottom. So it goes from the AC compressor to the crankshaft pulley. Okay, you can see on the back side right there, this is the crankshaft pulley. From the AC compressor, you will go to the alternator all the way up. You need to make sure you go, okay, in the teeth. Everything needs to be lining up. After that, okay, you will need to come on the water pump. Okay, right here. Now this is a little bit of a tight spot here. Okay, you can see how it's about to go on the water pump. Okay, perfect. Like that. Now, it's very important, guys, to make sure that on the alternator it's in all the grooves, on the crank pulley the same way, and on the AC compressor. Once that is done, okay, you get the tensioner and you start turning clockwise until you get the belt tight. Okay, check it out, it's already getting tight. Now you need to have a little bit of slack, but not much at all. Okay, perfect, that's it, right there. Because if you get it too tight, you have too much stress on the bearings and the belt. You need to get that side bolt tightened. And after that, we need to get this one tight. Next, start your vehicle, guys, with the AC compressor on and headlights on. And if you don't hear a belt squeak, you're good to go. You might need to re-tighten it after about 500 miles because it might stretch a little bit if you installed a new belt. But the procedure is super easy. So, that's how you guys replace the belt. Let's start it now. So let's see if it's going to squeak now. Nope, headlights are on, AC compressor is on, and the belt is not squeaking. So, that's how you replace the belt, guys. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and many more videos to come.